So let's get to the main topic of today, that is SaaSblazer, where we are, what we have done, our personal project, if anyone wants to share their experience and so on. I'm going to go quickly to a few support ticket centers. You guys know that that's a gold mine there. If you go every day, you will see what everyone is struggling with, what is the new thing that is coming up, what is the new error, and so on. So I'm going to go to this one real quick, and then I will show some demos of projects that we have been working on. So the first one is adding an icon to the layout group or header. If you see here, there are a lot of, like, we always have to think that SAF application are regular WinForms, web forms, and Blazor applications. So everything that you can do there, everything that you can do in ASP.NET Core, you will be able to do it here. So right here, if you see, they show you how to, through CSS, find the class that you need, add the picture, change colors, do anything you want. So that's just, I just bring that to this to your, to the SAFers attention, so you can know how you can address some of the requirements that you might have. So let's move to the next one. The next one, they are doing a HTML format text, and they want to add it in the Blazor application, and they were going to do it through the rich text document, but that one wasn't supported yet. So they were recommending to use the HTML editor. And what I'm bringing this up, because one article that is really good is this one, how to integrate a custom DevX string component and bind it to a data source. So most of the time, if you can, if you have seen it in JavaScript, if you have seen it in any other framework, you can integrate it here. Blazor will allow that possibility to use JavaScript Unterod to come and bring any other custom control. So you pretty much are in control of anything that you want to achieve. And we will see a couple examples there. And you will see that we can do a property editor if it's just for a property. We can do a list editor if it's for just a list view. We can do a view item. So we have all those choices available in our toolbox. So let's continue. One thing, just again, the logo that SaaSblazor has is monochromatic. So in certain cases, it will have this black background. So a way to fix that is to put the image in the background image URL instead of in the mask. So let's continue. I'm just showing you a couple of links, and I will add this to our meetup post on my blog, so you guys later can have this. Again, how can I integrate the pivot grid? We don't have a pivot grid still on Blazor, but we can integrate anyone, any other one. And it could not be even DevExpress. I'm really a fan of DevExpress, and I will actually give this recommendation to Dennis. I would love for all the Blazor demos from DevExpress to be PWA, to have several type of things, because for example, I saw Sam Basu from Telerik doing a talk about the future of Blazor and so on, and he took one of their demos, downloaded, made a PWA, show caches, show offline support. So that would be amazing when I'm showing to, when I'm like, I'm really excited about everything that is coming, and when I want to show it in a talk, that would be amazing to be able to present it. But again, we can again integrate any control, and we'll see a couple options. This one, I like this one because this is the other way around. We always talk about Blazor and how it has this really interop with JavaScript. This way, we're doing the other way around. So we are doing one of our methods, and we'll call it JS invocable. And then from our DevExtreme component, we're calling C#. So how amazing is that? We can do anything. We can call from .NET to JavaScript and from JavaScript to .NET. So let's continue. Color themes. We have a lot of themes, a lot of colors, but even those themes, we can customize it. So if we go and we say, okay, I want the color white, but I want maybe not the orange. I want my primary to be another color. We can come here and do some modifications and get that part done. Everything is in the tip of our hands. So this is another nice one, because again, SAF in you, if you guys know me, I'm in love with SAF. SAF is my day in and my day out, and all the controls from, and Blazor is the second one. So everything that we can do in a regular ASP.NET Core application, we can do it here. And one thing is, like, we are using Blazor in our mobile phones. So how we can detect about if it's mobile, if it's a tablet, if it's PC. So right here, there is a nice solution about doing it through the WebSocket protocol and getting that information header in the HTTP context. So a lot of solution is not only on the framework, it's also in the frame, in this frame. Where are we hosting it? Where, how are we doing it? So those are really nice solutions. And that's why the community provides so much to us, provide all this experience, all this value that we can reuse. So same here, how to obtain the HTTP context. And one thing that I like about the SAF Blazor implementation is that we have that service provider that allows to get a lot of service already implemented for Dev Express, and we can also include our own services. So that's a nice solution. Let's continue. Log out for a custom URL. We are going to show that one, and pretty much here what they do is just redirect. Let's say that when you log out, you want to send them to a page of your company information. You can do that so they can get some type of advertising or some type of things. So let's continue. If we have seen this example before, we were doing a custom view item, putting in the little view zone. Right now in 20.6, we already have our Blazor action container. So how many times have we had an action inside the detail view? A lot of time, and we know that tutorial in and out. So right now we can do that. So that's, again, another, I'm seeing Blazor getting better by the day. If you guys follow my blog, you remember that I did a post about integrating the dashboard module, the dashboard control into the SAF application. And I'm really happy that DevExpress already is providing their original tutorial, their original that it will be updated, that will be up to date. And right here is all the steps about even from running the NPM, running all the control and everything you need to get dashboards in your SAF applications. Okay, one thing about how to show a loading and spinning indicator, progress indicator. So if we just talk about the service provider that has, we can see here, look how nice is this. In the bottom click, we say invoice sync, and we call the loading indicator show and the loading indicator high, and we do our length operation inside those two calls. So that's a really nice user-friendly and a good user experience to let the user know, hey, we're doing something in the background. It will take just a second. Let's continue. So right here, I haven't tested this one, but I will definitely do it and create a video for the YouTube channel about how to use an image stored as the web application. And right here are all the steps of how to get that image that we store and then put it as the logo for application. So this is, again, we had this example already for web forms. So if you guys remember, I showed that in one of the meetups before. So now we are able to achieve it on Blazor. And how to use a fully custom login page in Blazor UI. So let me start showing something so I don't bore you guys too much. Let's show the first demo that I want to present. So let's think that you guys want to have a public page that it has information about your company. Say, okay, we are the Signal framework. This is our information, but you want to do it in SAF. You want to, like, they can have a login that is SAF and they can get inside and they can do whatever they want. So we can definitely do that. We can have a public page outside of our SAF application that is going to present all the information that we need. It will be our business card. This is who we are, what the service we offer, that everything we need. And then we can have a login button that it will redirect you to the login of the SAF application. So right here, this is a simple proof of concept, simple demo. So we have a landing page here. We can have a register button where they can add all this information, my website, my anything. And then we pretty much click login, and that will take us to the login page of SAF. So we are seeing that the possibilities of what we can achieve are really nice. So let's close this one and let's show another one that I think that is pretty cool. Okay, let's show, we're using here integrating the custom control of the Synfusion wizard to create a wizard inside of SAF. So SAF is giving us authentication, validation, appearance rule, a lot of module, dashboard, reports, but we need to have a wizard control. And because DevExpress doesn't have one right now, we can use anyone. We can use Synfusion, we can use Ratzen, we can use any other type of control that we need. So let's wait for a second to load and we'll see it in action. Jose, can you be checking the chat or Manuel in case someone is asking
questions? Of course.
Okay. Coffee is good. Okay, right here, if you see again our regular SAF application, and we have a wizard, and I think that it will give me the trial of the Synfusion, but let's close it out for a second. I need to put my license there. The Synfusion trial expired, but what I want to present is the idea that we can do anything. So we have here our application, and we have, let me make it big. We have here just a form that we're going to be next to the next one. Next, And we're going to be showing any type of control inside of SAF application. And all this information, we can map it to a persistent class. And that persistent class will be in SAF and will be allowing SAF to take care of all the CRUDS operation and everything for us. And right here, we can get as specific as possible. So right here, I can say how many people, 5, and it will allow me to do 5 more gathering information for those ones. So we have here also more information. This is a big one. We can select, we can upload files. Anything that we can do, we can integrate in SAF. Let's move to the next one. Let me close this one. Let's do a simple one. There is a SAF here that I think that he will like here because he was asking about PDF, so he will like this demo. I hope that my whole goal of showing all these demos, you guys get as excited as I am of what we can achieve. Like, there is no limit. It's just whatever you can imagine. Give me a design, we can put it. We can integrate any control, any HTML, CSS, 5, any JavaScript. The limitations are time and budget. That's it.
That's the neat thing about doing it in a browser, because it is the versatile thing we have. So, and it's easy to integrate. It makes the whole package.
Got it. So if you see here, pretty much we're using the file attachment module. We're loading a file, and I selected the one of our syllabus for our SAFRS training course. And pretty much then we can add a PDF viewer here that adds that control and pretty much show it to the user. So anything is possible. Just give me a control, give me some requirements, and we're good to go. So here is our syllabus for getting started with XPO. And let's move to the next. And I have one that is really interesting that I think that you guys will like a lot. So let me show you this one. This is one of the one that I like the most. So have anyone here use SAF with IoT? Let's show it. Let's show that we can read some values from an IoT device and then show some type of dashboard for them. Is there any question on the chat? I don't think so.
No, not.
Okay, so let's log in. So if you see here, we can select a place, and in the place we can add a panel, and we are going to select a device, and this device could be anything, a temperature, any type of device. Then we can select what is the type of that we want to show. We're going to put any name. We're going to put the size, a data source, so we know what is coming. Color if we want to, and we can put a unit that is Fahrenheit, whatever. So pretty much, if you see, we can have right away something that is reading from a device, is sending the data to our database, and then from there, we can do any visualization. We can do any type of functionality that we need. We can, again, move and so on. Okay?
Nice.
Let's move to the next one. All right. I don't know if you guys follow Michael Washington. He's a nice that is on Blazor. He's on the Octane framework. He's a really big on open source community. This guy is amazing. I don't follow him. I pursue him. I don't know if that's the word. He's really nice on everything that he's building in Blazor. And he had a project that is called Dynamic Survey that when I saw it, I said, this is going to be amazing to integrate it on SAF. So I will show it here real quick. And you guys tell me, what do you think about it? So pretty much right here, you see we have a few surveys, 3, 2, 1, whatever, and let's make a new one so you guys see what I'm saying. If I go to survey, I'm gonna create one, and I will call it survey 4 because I'm that creative, and let's put a few questions. Is SAF, Blazor, awesome? It will be required. It will be a drop down. And let's put a few choices. Absolutely. And the second one, of course, there is no choice to say no here. So, okay. So with that one, we save it and let's go to surveys now. If you see here, we have survey four here. It's SAF, Blazor, Awesome. We already have our choices. We submit a response and we can even have a graph of every user that has done. Right now it's just one because it was just me right now. But if we go, I don't know, to survey one that I think, you see, I tested with different users and we have three saying yes, two different saying no. So and I just show you with just one question. You can put as many questions. It can be a multiple choice question. It can be just a free text. It could be anything. So this is really, I think that this is amazing. And with the SAF security system that we can create permission and say, okay, there is a survey admin to manage the survey part. There is a survey user. There is so we can do all these crazy things here.
Yeah, and also with the thing you showed the with the landing page, you also can integrate that outside of XIF world. So you can put it outside and only protect the questions, but the answers can be from the internet. Yeah,
exactly. No, what I want to point out there is the same solution. We just have a component that we are exposing public outside of SAF security system. We are not doing any crazy thing. It's just the same component that we could integrate inside. We're putting it outside, if that makes sense.
Jose, I know it's just to clarify that it is just Blazor and it's just a web application. And so you can mix and match and do all the kind of stuff, but without having all the trouble doing all that graph stuff yourself and so on. So sometimes that's the harder part. It's not the public part. It's the other part that's hard.
Exactly. So if you see here, they are asking, can I do something like this on SAF?
Yeah.
You can. You can use CSS and move your center login to the left and put some picture on the right. You can get really custom. Again, and if you have a designer or a wizard in a CSS, JavaScript, that will HTML5, that wouldn't hurt. It's not. We do our best, but we are not the designers or a front-end part. So a few more. If we see here, there is a separate way that we can load the iLoading indication provider service. And if we saw it before through JavaScript, but right here we're seeing that we can pretty much get that service and call the whole and release. And that will as well give you the loading indicator. So we have choices here and really good ones. So how can upload, play a video in SAF Blazor? SAF Blazor is a regular ASP.NET Core application. If you Google up how you're doing it in ASP.NET Core application, in a Blazor application, you can integrate it here. We have an application that we cannot show because it's through NDA that we are actually asking the user to record in the microphone. And through JavaScript, we record that, we get that file, send it to C#, send it to our site, what we like, and then we use it. We could send it to an API or so on. So right here, any solution that you can find, like search Blazor Video Player, that will work as well. So actions availability, one thing, I just left this link because I think that I have seen a couple of people asking this because we have used on web forms and that the actions are always there, but in Blazor it gets more user-friendly. So if it's selection that you have to click on it, it won't show the action until you actually click on it. So one of those choosing is delete. Until you click it, you will not see the delete action. I think that has a few sufferers confused. So I just wanted to bring that up here. Before we were doing I don't know if you remember, we were doing a component and we were adding, getting the grid and showing the summary on the bottom and somewhere customizations. We don't need it to do anymore. Right now in the model, we can select the summary and we're good to go. And that's in 20.2.6, so that's available for you guys to use it already. So localization as well. That's available and that's getting better by the day. Wanted to just bring out that in the OAuth sample, if you're OAuth, any type of OAuth provider, if they can create a claim principle, if they can do, you can integrate as well. It doesn't have to be only. Please, Manuel.
You can ask me. I got a lot of questions about OAuth. In the past, because of my video I did with Xenial Identity, it isn't something special. It is just OpenID Connect. It's nothing special. But if you have a task, ask me. I am happy to help you.
Yeah. So one thing that I also wanted to show is like, this is a really interesting ticket. So if you want to bypass the login page in SAF Blazor, you can create a sign-in middleware. And you pretty much add in the claim the username and the user ID, and the user ID from 20.2.5, and you are good to go. You are in.
Never use this in production. No, it's fine. If you do it for testing or to just put in the username, totally fine.
Nice. So some other staff wanted to ask their own information in the about info that we see on the Blazor page. And we have it right here. You just get the about info instance and you add your own information right there. Now, same thing, another service provider, another service that we can get the required service, iConfiguration, and you will have access to your connection string of everything you need. Again, this is the same flow that ASP.NET Core is, so you can get the iConfiguration and you're good to go. This is just something that there was some type of difference between the actions in the nested views and the root views, and that's fixed in 20.7. So if you guys are having that issue, don't worry, that's fixed, update, and you're good to go. Mm-hmm. So I was working a lot with B2C lately, and one thing that we wanted to do is use the login from B2C, not the login from SAF, and then reuse that one and send the information to SAF. So right here, I actually... and that's why reading the tickets are so amazing, because you are having an issue and I don't know how or why most of the time that I'm having an issue, I find the answer right here somehow. So you can do pretty much another middleware, and we see it right here, where we can pretty much redirect the user to the login screen that we want instead of the one from SAF and then go from there. So
yeah, that's the thing I used in my XML demo as well, yeah.
And I also saw this link that I saw that it was really interesting. And actually, Hoche has a SAF Blazor REST API solution that is really nice that we show in a meetup another time. But what I wanted to show here is that the SAF Blazor use the routes, API sign-in, API sign-out, API challenge, and so on, when they are actually doing the authentication. So if you're trying to integrate an API in there, you need to check that your route is not getting intercepted or it's not getting mixed up with those. Just bringing that to your attention. And the last one that I think that is really interesting, of course, is not something that is on the roadmap or anything, but I just wanted to discuss it for just a second. It's like SAF and MAUI. MAUI has a lot of now boost is coming in .NET 6. We're gonna be able to deliver with just one code, iOS, Android, Mac, Windows, and so on. And of course, we are focusing right now in the web part. We are actually focus on the Blazor server part, but what I wanted to, what the only thing that I wanted to show this is because I have to give a talk about, I did a talk in Blazor Mobile Binding about talking about you can have a Blazor application, you can have a PWA, and from the, if you want a more device specific APIs, you can do Electron and you can have all the platform, and then you can use iOS and you can use, because there is a Blazor a web view that you can have in your application that is actually using, is running in the mobile, is not using a web server or anything. So what it caught my interest in there is like, again, Blazor, SAF Blazor, and regular Blazor server apps. So if you think about this, I just want to show the solution that I presented in that talk. So we have right here a Blazor library component that is a pretty much a component for with Blazor that is just a clock showing the time regular, calling JavaScript just to show that the JavaScript interrupt is really first-hand citizen. And then we have a Blazor app, and then we have pretty much our summoning application with iOS, Android, macOS, Windows, and so on. And just as a proof of concept, I added a SAF Blazor app. So if we pretty much call run our Blazor app, it will be the regular counter fetch data, and pretty much I just replace it with a clock, just to show the concept. So let's wait for a second and let's see it happen. That's it. There is a breakpoint here that I was testing. Just a clock, nothing crazy, nothing but just to prove a concept. So that same clock And hopefully the demo gods will help me today, because every time that I try to run something in Xamarin in a presentation, I have some hiccups. But let's see it quickly. It's taking a little bit, as always, Andre always take a little bit to load. But while that is loading, I don't know you guys, but I'm really, really excited about SAFLASER. Every time that we have a new proof of concept, new project, I think that like, what we can achieve here is amazing. And the performance is looking really, really good. It's a dream come true. It's something that we have been waiting for a long time, and we will also solve for mobile's part. Mm-hmm. Okay, well, I can be saying a few more things while that is loading, because I don't want to be. So pretty much if we see here, we have our same pages, our same Tracer component, and that's inside the Xamarin application. We have a referencing in our Blazor app. We can see that in the projects. We have the Tracer crash library component. In our mobile application, we have a Tracer crash library component. And what I wanted to show here is in SAF, we have a Tracer crash library component. So it's the same library. We are not changing a code. We are not doing nothing. And we are being able to show it in Blazor, in mobile, and mobile includes, when I say in Blazor mobile binding, that includes iOS, Android, Windows, and Mac. And we are also showing it now in SAF Blazor. So yeah, .NET and MAUI maybe is not in the roadmap, but we can reuse a lot of components and a lot of things from one project to another one. So. Come on, show that. Okay, if you see the same component, it's giving me the same breakpoint, and let's wait for it. And you have the clock. Took a little bit, but we can show it. So now let's go to SAF Blazor. SAF Blazor, the one thing that is good to mention is that because we are using a component from another one, we need to add to our additional assemblies that separate assembly where we're bringing that component, because he needs to know where to look for that component that we created. But with that one, you see, it's loading our solution on SAF Blazor, and now it will hit the same breakpoint as has hit the Blazor by itself and the mobile application. And now it will do it in SAF. You see, it just hit the breakpoint. It hits inside, actually, it hits inside the JavaScript.
Oh, that's awesome.
And it didn't show it. Well, that happens. I don't know. I have to check that why I didn't show it. But if you see, it's the say the component clock component. It seems like somehow it didn't detect the ID. I just was putting this together in the morning, so I thought that. But again, you see the idea, the point of concept. So I will create a video showing this part again that now it doesn't show. I don't want to take much time because still Manuel have to show the layout model builder and Jorge has to show a sim framework. But hopefully with all these quick demos and all these tickets, because pretty much that's a great source of information, we can see the possibilities and the things that we can achieve with SAF Blazor.